I am an American, my name is Jonathan Gibbs, and I live in Switzerland. I'm a volunteer activist with Amnesty International, and today I would like to talk to you about the group within Amnesty International Switzerland that I am involved with. The name of this group is Queeramnesty. We are registered within Amnesty as number 210. And we focus on LGBTI topics. So, we're a group of about 20 core activists. And within these 20 core activists, I would say there are about 10 of us that are interested in all aspects of Queeramnesty's activities, and maybe 5 people who really are there for one specific event each year. For example, the Pride event that we support as an Amnesty group each summer in Zurich. There are also about 400, there are 400 total members, and so most of them support financially and receive our newsletter, which we send out about 2 or 3 times each year. Here's our most recent newsletter, and you can see it will tell you a little bit about what we, Queeramnesty within Amnesty, care in particular about. For example, the activist Tianzi in China, who is in danger of being tortured in China. Also in Iraq, it's a very difficult situation. So, we have a petition going on protesting all of the violence against gay men in Iraq. This petition is the same style of petition that Amnesty does on many different topics, and this was with the support and collaboration of the overall level of Amnesty Switzerland. Here are just some examples of what Queeramnesty is concerned about. Serbia, attacks in Serbia. The new anti-homosexuality law in Uganda. From last year, the Lithuanian parliament, a new homophobic law. And lastly, a homosexual couple in Malawi who was sentenced to 14 years in prison. Two of these examples, you may notice, are from Africa, and 2 are from Eastern Europe. That shows you pretty much our focus. About half of our focus is on Eastern Europe and the other half on Africa, because those are areas, regions, are where most of the countries are located, where most of the most serious discrimination and human rights abuses happens against LGBTI people. One last example of what Queeramnesty is concerned about and what we do at the international level with letters, with petitions, with actions and campaigns. For example, our letter to Saudi Arabia, which we worked on in coordination, actually, with the women's rights group in Zurich. This letter was prepared by the women's rights group. And basically, this is an example of a 27-year-old man in Saudi Arabia who has been sentenced to 500 lashes and 5 years in prison, 5 years imprisonment, because they allege that he is homosexual. This is a letter that people not just in Switzerland, also in Germany and in other Amnesty International sections are writing as we speak, and this urgent action is running until December 24th. What about actual contact with victims of human rights abuses? Well, that is basically the other area that Queeramnesty is heavily involved in. We provide support to refugees living in Switzerland who are from a country that they had to flee because they were victims of violence, discrimination, trying to be killed by their own family, by the government, by paramilitary. Queeramnesty has been working with LGBTI refugees for about 10 years now, providing them with support, networking them with the local community, and doing what we can to help them.